Brought it to him. He was right there. 50-50 all the way. And I can't believe the card tonight. They're still buzzing in the back about it. The Giant, Hogan, Nash, you name it, Savage, Piper, it's all here tonight.
Before this match gets underway, I want to let you know this coming Friday, tickets go on sale for Thunder, which will be held on April 22nd in Columbia, South Carolina, the Carolina Coliseum on the campus of University of South Carolina. Tickets on sale this Friday, March 27th at the Carolina Coliseum box office in all capital ticket outlets. And this Friday, March 27th, tickets go on sale for WCW returning to the Independence Arena in Charlotte. The date is April 25th, and tickets go on sale this Friday in the Arena Box Office in all Ticketmaster locations. Don't forget, this Friday as well, tickets go on sale in the Baltimore Arena this Friday, March 27th, for the Great American Bash pay-per-view, which will be Sunday, June 14th. Kurt Hennig and the Nitro Girls will be in the Baltimore Arena Friday, 10 a.m. to noon, when tickets go on sale.
Talk about the ultimate humiliation. Eddie Guerrero is forcing his nephew, Chavo Jr., to wear a T-shirt that says, "My favorite wrestler is Eddie Guerrero." And then, can you believe that? After Chavo's match, he talked about Chavo being an embarrassment to the entire family, apologizing to Chavo, Mondo, Hector, and even Mom.
Kaz Hayashi is the opponent for Eddie Guerrero here. Say, these fans here in Louisville, these fans, Freedom Hall, have been treated to one of the greatest nitros ever, and we're only halfway there. We've got another hour and a half to go, fans. Roddy Piper in the ring, returning to the ring for what, the first time?
Yeah, but not just in the ring with Randy Savage.
Randy Savage.
The world's most dangerous wrestler and probably the most schizophrenic human being walking the streets of this earth, Roddy Piper.
Against one of the world's most dangerous wrestlers and one of the most schizophrenic human beings ever walking the face of the earth in the Macho Man Randy Savage.
Ditto.
Here they go.
And it's just a shank of the evening.
Yes, it is. Hayashi went for the handshake, but no, Eddie Guerrero will have none of it. And now an uppercut, and Guerrero is Mr. Offense here. Hayashi in over the top, and a back elbow.
Plus, he's trying to prove a point, Tony, because earlier this evening, his nephew, Chavo Jr., lost to the Ultimo Dragon. And he said, "I'm going to show you how you attack and how you defeat a Japanese wrestler."
See, you gentlemen look at it a different way. You're thinking that Eddie Guerrero is nothing but a punk in the family. Turned his back on the family.
One, two, got a two count. That's what he's done,
and
that's what
he is. He's doing. He's trying to light a fire under his nephew. He's trying to do something for the family. I mean, this man should be held in high esteem.
To get out here in front of 12 million fans like he did moments ago and try to embarrass him, that is lighting a fire under him.
Well, maybe he's tried other ways and the man's just too dumb to learn.
You're talking about two totally different levels of experience, however. Moonsault, Eddie prepared, catches him in the midsection with a dropkick. Eddie Guerrero's been wrestling as a pro for over 10 years. His nephew, Chavo Guerrero Jr., is only in his second year as a professional wrestler.
Well, let me tell you this, Brain. I don't know where you come from, but the best way to get the most out of people is not to embarrass them in front of family members and peers.
No, you're right about that. You browbeat them when no one's looking.
Well, up on top. Down to the floor goes Eddie. And here comes Hayashi. Hayashi hit very hard as well.
Twisting tope suicida, a twisting suicide dive by Kaz Hayashi.
Run that by me again in English.
Suicide dive.
Thank you.
Wow.
Wow is right.
Both reading men, labels again on those cans.
Both men slow to get up. And Hayashi, as you see, hands on his hips on the far side. Chavo Jr. Hayashi, a physical drive kick from the top. Hayashi will make a quick cover. One, two, and Eddie goes to the ropes, grabs the bottom rope, and stops the count of the referee.
All of a sudden, Eddie's not doing so good here against Kaz Hayashi in his second ever neutral appearance.
Hayashi looking pretty darn good here.
It is.
You know, he'd love to see Eddie lose and take that T-shirt off and just throw it right at him. But then he'd be off the Christmas list, as we know.
Yeah, I bet you Eddie's like you. Buys no one anything. Up on top.
What a move.
That was just a defensive move. He used Hayashi's own momentum, just stuck the knee out and drove him back with a backbreaker, Mike.
Caught him in midair with that backbreaker. Never seen that one before.
Oh! Backbreaker. kicker from the far ropes goes in. He goes to the back now repeatedly on Hayashi here.
Second time with much more impact off the tilt-a-whirl.
Ladies and gentlemen, Roddy Piper and Randy Savage will battle in this broadcast in Hogan and Nash in a handicap match against the Giant. First time ever. Didn't come tonight. Hayashi reverses. Suplex, held his own, great balance by Guerrero.
And when you talk about Piper and Savage, you're talking about two people that know each other very well. Two people that are going to, you're not going to see a bunch of hammerlock, headlock, fancy switches, go behind. You're going to see the fight of your life. Sitting in your living room with your clicker and your little paw, you're going to see the fight of your life.
Eddie calling Chavo over here.
He says, this is how you do it.
Come on, it's a good look, Chavo. You'll learn something, maybe.
Deep, deep underhook this time. Has the wrist and the elbow hooked on the other hand. Here's a cover. One, two, and no.
Pump handle into the backbreaker again. Just a two count. Great fighting spirit by this youngster, Kaz Hayashi.
Hayashi trying to pull himself up. As you can see,
but he's taking three good shots to the back.
Well, one thing he needs to teach his nephew, Chavo Jr., is to shut out the bannering from the fans when he wants to be successful.
Well, you can't shut them people up. You know that.
I didn't say shut them up. I said to shut it out. Concentrate on your
shut it out is to shut them up.
No, you can't.
Why don't you shut up?
Would you stop it? Up. Now he tries to hook him and puts him on the top turnbuckle. Here comes Eddie again. Oh, my. Could be a superplex.
Several different options from the top. That's exactly what it is, superplex.
Not only did he send him down, he pushed off hard in the top turnbuckle. Extra leverage, power, force, hitting the mat for Eddie Guerrero. Could be time for the frog splash here, guys.
Well, that's the difference between the 10 years and the 2 years. Look at this.
All Eddie Guerrero. This one's over.
Take a look, Junior. Did you learn anything?
I don't think there's any question of the talent and the ability of Eddie Guerrero, champion over and over again in the sport. But it's the way he carries himself, the way he has disowned the family, that really gets under the skin of nephew Chavo Jr.
Talent and ability, Tony, have never been questioned. It's just attitude.
Wanted Chavo to raise his hand, demanded.
Oh, dragon out.
And the Ultimo Dragon bumps into Eddie on his way out.
Here to check on his countryman, Kaz Hayashi.
That's what he's done. Meanwhile, a little argument goes on south of the border here.
Are you apologizing? Who are you with? Him or me?
He's demanding Chavo from the ropes, and I think he slapped Chavo.
He's my nephew.
A deal's a deal.
I think he slapped Chavo for, as he said, letting the Ultimo Dragon bump into him.
A deal's a deal, but this is taking it a little bit too far, isn't it?
And well, I hate to get involved in family business, as you know.
What do you mean? You love to drag out dirty laundry, to stir things up. That's what you're made of, Brain.
You think I am a domestic and do housework?
Fans, let's take a very special look at one of the greatest wrestlers in the history of our sport, part of WCW.